Hi guys, today we are going to see how you can add a table of contents to your WordPress website. Let's say you have a website and you have a blog like this. Now if a visitor wants to read any content on your page, they have to scroll down. Instead of scrolling like this, you can add a list of topics on your page, and when someone visits your site, they'll be able to go to a specific section of your website by selecting the topic. You can do that easily by adding a table of contents to your website. So after watching this video, you'll be able to add a table of contents to your website like this. So let's get started. I'm Brian from Website Learners, and let's add a table of contents to our website. First, let's see our site. Here it is. This is the site where we are going to add the table of contents. Now to add the table of contents to our site, we are going to do two steps. The first step is to install a plugin. So to install the plugin, let's go to our WordPress dashboard. Now go to Plugins and click Add New. Now here, search for Easy Table of Contents. And you will get this plugin. Now this is the plugin which will help us add a table of contents to our posts or pages. So to install the plugin, let's click Install and then click Activate. So now we have successfully installed the plugin. Once you have installed the plugin, we can go to step 2, which is to choose where you want to add the table of contents. So to choose the table of contents, let's go to Settings and click Table of Contents. And you will get this page. Here you can see that we have a list of options where you can add the table of contents. Let's say you want to add table of contents to your posts. All you have to do is just enable this option. Once you've done that, just scroll down and click Save Changes. Okay, so now we have successfully enabled the table of contents. Once you have selected where you want to display the table of contents, we can now add the table of contents to our post. So to add the table of contents, let's go to Posts and click All Posts. And it will take you to this page. Here you can select the post for which you want to add the table of contents. I'm going to select this post. Once you have selected it, just scroll down. Here you can see, we have got a new section on our post. Now to add a table of content to this post, just enable this option. And next, you need to select the headings of your posts, which you want to display on your table. So I'm going to select these headings. Once you're done, just click Update. And the table of contents will be added to our post. Now if we go back to our website and click Refresh, you can see that the table of contents has been added to our post. Now if someone clicks on this heading, it will take them to that section of the post. This is how you can add the table of contents to your blog post. So now you know how to add the table of contents on your post. Now if you go to another blog post, you can see that we do not have the table of contents here. So like we did before, we need to add the table of contents to all your blog posts. Now instead of adding the table of contents for each post one by one, what if you want to automatically add the table of contents to all the posts at the same time? So next, let's see how you can automatically add the table of contents to all your posts. So to automatically add the table of contents, let's go to our WordPress dashboard and then go to Settings and click Table of Contents. It will take you to this page. And here you can see that we have an option called Auto Insert. Now if you want to automatically add the table of contents to all your posts, just enable Post here. Once you've done that, just scroll down and click Save Changes. Now if we go back to our website and click Refresh, you can see that the table of contents has been added to this post. Now if you click on a heading, it will take you to that particular content. Okay, this is how you can add the table of contents to all your posts on your site. Now let's say you want to remove the table of contents from this particular post. How do you remove it? So to do that, just go back to your WordPress dashboard. Now just scroll down. And here you can see that we have an option called Limit Path. Here, you need to paste the path link of the post from which you want to remove the table of contents. So to get the path link, let's go to our post. Now here you can see, this is the path link of your post. So just copy this link with a slash. Now let's go back to this tab. And then paste it here. Now click Save Changes. As soon as you click Save Changes, the table of contents will be removed from your post. So to check it, let's go to our post and click Refresh. You can see that the table of contents has been removed. Okay, now you know how to remove the table of contents from a particular post. But what if you want to remove a heading from the table? So next, let's see how you can remove a particular heading from the table of contents. So to remove the heading, first, let's copy the heading which you want to remove. As I want to remove this heading, I'm going to copy this. Once you have copied it, now click Edit Post. And then scroll down. Here you will find an option called Exclude Headings. Now here, paste the heading which you have copied earlier. And click Update. And the heading will be removed from the table. Now if we go to our site, as you can see, we now have this heading. Now if we click Refresh, you can see that the heading has been removed from the table of contents. Okay, next, let's go to the bonus part of this tutorial where we see how we can add a table of contents on the sidebar like this. So to add the table to the sidebar, let's go to our WordPress dashboard, go to Appearance, click Widgets, and you will get this page. Here you can see the sidebar of our website. Now to add the table on our sidebar, just drag and drop the table of contents widget here. And you will get this box. Here, enter a title for your table. I'm going to enter Contents. Once you've done that, click Save. And then click Done. And the table of contents will be added to our sidebar. So now let's go to our site and click Refresh. You can see that our table of contents has been added to the sidebar. And as you can see, we also have the table of contents here. Now if you don't want the table of contents in both the places, you can remove it from the posts. Next, let's see how you can remove the table of contents from posts. So to do that, let's go to our WordPress dashboard. As you can see, the table of contents is enabled for posts. So let's disable these. Now scroll down and click Save. Now if we go back to our site and click Refresh, you can see that The table of contents has been removed from posts. Okay. Now if you scroll down, you can see that the table of contents is also going up. Instead of this, what if you want to fix your table of content like this? So to fix the table of contents, first you need to install a plugin. So to install a plugin, let's go to our WordPress dashboard. Now go to plugins and click add new. Now here, search for fixed widgets. And you will get this plugin. So this is the plugin which will help us to fix the table on our website. So to install this plugin, let's click install. And then click activate. So now we have successfully installed the plugin. Once you have installed the plugin, now to fix the table, let's go to appearance and click widgets. And you will get this page. Now click the table of contents widget, which we have added to the sidebar. So to fix the table on the sidebar, just enable this option and click save. Now your table will be fixed on the sidebar. So to check it, let's go back to our site and click refresh. Now if we scroll down, you can see that the table of contents is fixed. And it shows a particular heading as we scroll down the page. Okay, so that's it guys. This is how you can add the table of contents to your WordPress website. Now if you want to learn more about WordPress, you can check out a complete WordPress course by clicking the link below this video. And also make sure you subscribe to Website Learners to get more videos like this one. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.